Yeah.
Boy, hello there, and welcome back to Spore. Today, I'm trying to complete the hardest achievements out there, from causing mass genocide, blowing up countless of planets, and even killing an epic.
Yeah.
But before we can actually do those achievements, we must firstly name our planet and start off the game by being launched in a big fucking rock. And now, welcome to the stealth stage.
Hello, how are you? I am under the water.
Where we must earn the achievement completest. Basically, we must obtain all of the cell stage parts. And we will do that by hunting down some innocent cells. And boom, we have already obtained our first part, the spike. But sadly, obtaining the others won't be this easy, because the other cells are far stronger and faster. So in that case, I shall devour a few more weak cells in order to get myself some DNA points and give our little friend over here some more fins for extra speed. La 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 la. Well, would you look at that? I think I just found my new target. Hello my friend, I think it is time for you to say goodbye to your life privileges. And boom! That's another part.
No, my virgin!
In that case, I guess it is time for me to once again get some extra fins, so that I will be more versatile and I'll be able to hunt down the bastard far easier. Now, I just have to get this guy's sucker thingy and these poor buffoons electric butt. And with that, the only thing that remains from the cell stage is to eat some more flesh, get a small brain, and prepare our little comrade for the next stage. So, I shall give him some nipples, a butt, this thingy, and spikes. Anyway, with that, it is time to go to land. As you can see, currently our comrade is legless, because, well, I'm trying to get the slugger achievement. But that will quickly change, because I will befriend my neighbors to get some DNA points, partake in some explicit activities with a female, and give our little abomination arms for legs. Now, you might be wondering if this will actually work, since it looks like it has legs, but rest assured, because I have no fucking clue. Okay, besides that, I'm also give him some feet for dancing and running, wings, and a mouth, with which we shall begin our second and third achievement, befriending 20 species and making 20 species go extinct. Now, I usually like committing mass genocide first because, well, it is very fun, but sadly, we will do that later, since it's far easier to befriend species at the start than it is at the end.
So I was mistaken.
Okay, I mean, at first I was befriending creatures like I was the coolest guy in the world. But after I got a bigger brain, I figured out the stupider you are, the easier it is to make friends. Like, look at this. I can't befriend these pathetic humans. And I can just barely befriend these fuckers. But you see, that will not stop us, because I will use the DNA points I acquired to upgrade our creature with the charm ability and the most important ability that you need for this achievement, the sync ability. And I don't have it. Well, shit. In that case, I might try to compromise by investing the DNA points into the other skills. Yeah. Anyway, after my family decided to leave me for that, I befriended this guy.
Hello there.
And continued befriending creatures until I got an even bigger brain, which made the process of getting friends even harder. Okay, so I think I might actually have a solution to my problem. The Croc Kisser Mouth. Okay, I know it's a weird name, but it will grant us a level 2 sing ability. Which isn't really the best, but it's way better than level 1, okay? And with these, we still have to spend an abnormal amount of time pretending to be nice and having to abolish all of our morals to please. Finally, god damn it. Yes! So, it is time to equip my comrade with the most efficient killing abilities.
Baby, that's what I've been waiting for.
So, comrades, you know what time it is. Yes, it is time for death and destruction. You beast shall feel my wrath. There is no use running from me, because going
to heaven is your only option.
Would you look at that? I gained another achievement. The Devourer. Well, that's cool, but we have a new problem. I've been just flying around for 10 minutes and I can't find any species
because I literally befriended every single one of them.
A few moments later.
Oh wait, never mind. I actually managed to find an unexplored area where I should finish off the rest of the species
and obtain the achievement.
Now, if you think we're done with the creature stage, you'd be mistaken, because we still have to complete two very epic achievements. And one of those is General Custer. In simple words, you have to lead 30 of your allies to their death. And what better way to do that than to sacrifice a bunch of Marcellos to some epics. So yes, the process is very simple. I will befriend 3 Marcellos and then I will repeatedly sacrifice them to the epic.
No, I just have to do this 10 times all over again.
One eternity later.
I have sacrificed countless of men, women, and even children, all for this achievement. Now all that remains is that we avenge them and hunt down this epic. Yes, you will suffer, you will die, you will face the wrath of my men and feel your balls being beaten off. And boom, with that, the interesting creature stage achievements have been finished. So, we shall give our comrades 3 heads for the Cerberus achievement and max stats for the max power achievement. Alright, it is now time to discover fire. And boom, welcome to the tribal stage, where we shall begin the hardest achievement up until now.
Watchful parent.
Basically, I have to beat the tribal stage without losing a single member. And if you ever played the tribal stage, you would know that you're constantly attacked by random tribes, epics, and constant hunger. And literally all of your men die in mere flipping seconds. But if that wasn't dumb enough yet, I'm going to do this with the vicious achievement. Which means I have to attack and kill every village out there without losing a single member. So, we shall begin our journey by viciously attacking these beasts and harvesting their bodies for food, so that we can make a couple babies and construct a weapon hut, which will bestow our man with the best tribal stage weapon out there, the axe. With this, we might actually stand a chance of completing the achievement. But just to be safe, I'ma brainwash these beasts into submission and then attack the pink village. Come on, man, you got this. Make Marcello proud. Okay, the chieftain is low on health, so we shall quickly send him back to the base and finish off the rest of the baboons. And as well, their hut. Well, that was quite easy. But now,
shit, he's starting to get real.
Because the other villages now have 9 members, and all of them are equipped with weapons. So, we will have to resort to petty tactics, like attacking their food gatherers, and targeting their children, so that they cannot reproduce. Well, I'll be damned. I have absolutely no clue how in God's name that actually worked. Anyway, I'ma feed my man with the best meat and vodka so that they can regain their strength and once again march onward to the next village. Yes, you puny dumbasses shall face my wrath.
Wait,
no! Marcello!
Well, let's try this again.
Now for fuck's sake! This time, I will wait for their food gatherers in the bushes and swiftly attack them. And then I shall continue my rampage until every single one of them is dead. Well, that was certainly easy because it took me half an hour of trying just to get this one singular villa. And boom, our base has been upgraded to 12 members, which you might think is actually a good thing, but believe me when I say that it's not, because we now have to face the strongest village out there, the Orange Village. In all honesty, I have no real plan, so I'll just make a medic station and pray for the best outcome.
A few moments later.
So status update. After 30 minutes of dying, this won't work.
So I came up with a very big brain plan. You see, I will provoke the villagers and immediately run like a coward. So that I will lure half of them out of the village and done. After I'm finished taking the life privileges, I can finally destroy the rest of the village and their hut. And boom, we have now gotten the achievement. Alright, I guess it is now time to go to the mother stage where we shall gain the achievement of destroying every city with a nuke and colonizing the planet by hoarding all of the spice geysers just like the British. So, we shall begin our journey by getting the fastest tank there is and then quickly capturing every spice geyser on the continent. Wait, no, please, no! Okay, now with the money I have gained from the spice geysers, I'll upgrade the city to make a ton of money. Since, well, you could guess that nukes are quite expensive. But the second thing we need for the nuke ability is capturing all of the cities on the continent. So, it is time to craft a ton of tanks and start my conquest of the continent. Yes, bow down to me, peasants!
And boom, we have gained all of the four cities on continent, and as well a port city, so we can make a boat and capture the spice geysers in the ocean. Anyway,
you know what time it is now.
It is time for death and destruction.
And boom, we have captured all of the cities and all of the spice guys, which means that we have finished all of the achievements from the mother stage and we can continue to the space stage, where we shall begin the most entertaining achievements up until now. Finding Earth, blowing up Earth, and destroying 20 planets. So, let's begin by creating our beautiful spaceship and completing our first mandatory mission. Going to this planet and scanning the ship. After that, I'm supposed to go to another star system, but I won't do that, since I will instead do a glitch where you repeatedly bash your mouse to move between the star systems. And with that, we can get the frequent flyer achievement, which will level up my ship and allow me to travel far, farther distances in space. Anyway, now I'm just scan this city, destroy these weird chips, and complete the mandatory mission. Alright, the only thing we need now to blow up the planet is the planet buster, which needs a fuck tonload of money to be bought, and also I have to conquer 50 planets in order to just unlock it. So I guess it is time for me to start committing some war crimes. And if I want money, I'll just sell all of the buildings from my captured planets and buy some weapons of mass destruction, like this bomb, which will allow me to quickly destroy the cities on some planets.
Yes, suffer mortals, you shall taste the bite of my dip!
Okay, they have now been unalived. So I'll buy an even stronger bomb coupled with a wormhole key, which, if it wasn't obvious, will allow us to travel through wormholes to the center of the galaxy, where we shall meet the most aggressive species out there, the Grooks. And I will quickly destroy all of the cities.
Yes,
die! Okay, you know what? I've changed my mind. I'm not doing this 50 more times. So, I'll acquire the planet booster in some other illegal ways. And now that we have the planet buster, it is time for me to find Earth in this humongous galaxy. Like, Jesus Christ, how do people expect aliens to find us? It's like searching for a fucking sane person at a pride. Well, I guess I'll blow up a random planet to keep myself entertained. Okay, I think I'm actually might have found it. It's supposedly somewhere over here. Wait. What the fuck? You gotta be shitting me! Bro, it's right over there. And I can't reach it! Wait a minute. That actually worked? Well, I'll be damned. I acquired another range upgrade. So, it is now time to go to our solar system, colonize the moon, and go to the planet.
Okay,
I think I'm currently right over America, so hopefully I don't cause 9/11 again. Oh, look, I found my country. I wonder what would happen if I do that. Anyway, it is now time to blow up the planet. And after that, I'ma just blow up the rest of the planets to get the achievement.